Hi, welcome to this How Do I video about using APIs from Dynamics 365 with your Connect app. At the end of this video, you will know what APIs are available and how to use them. We will do that by following these steps. First, we will look at the available APIs and where to find them. Then we will look at security and how to set a web service key that can be used during development. And after that, we will use an API Explorer to demonstrate how to use the APIs and go over a number of possibilities and scenarios. APIs are used to connect from the outside world to Dynamics 365 and to read and write data. It does not require any Dynamics 365 programming skills or knowledge. The only thing you need to know is which APIs are available and how they can be used. The Dynamics 365 environment has a standard endpoint that can be used for all tenants. The correct tenant will be selected based on the user credentials. As you can see, there is a version number in the URL. Any breaking changes in the APIs will result in a new version to guarantee backward compatibility with previous versions. It is also possible to use tenant-specific endpoints. This is useful for development and test scenarios. All APIs are exposed as OData web services. That means that they can accept and return JSON data. This is a list of available APIs as of today. New APIs are added on a monthly basis. The APIs are divided in functional areas like general information on company level, finance, sales, purchasing, etc., etc. To call an API, you need to authenticate. There are two ways for authentication. For the production endpoint, you need to use an OAuth token. Based on this token, the endpoint can find the correct tenant. The tenant-specific endpoint, which can be used for development, also allows to use basic authentication. Basic authentication uses a web service key as a password. This web service key can be used on the user card. Let's switch to the Dynamics 365 sandbox and open a user card. In the ribbon bar, you see the action Change Web Service Key. Click on this action and specify an expiry date for the web service key. Then, on the user card, open the web service key tab and copy the key for usage in your development environment. To test the behavior of APIs, we can use an API Explorer. Those explorers are platform independent and do not require any specific programming language. With tools like Postman and Fiddler, you can easily explore the APIs and how they work. Then you can implement those APIs in a development platform of your choice. Here you see Postman. We are going to use this tool to explore the possibilities of the Dynamics 365 APIs. In the collection settings, you can see that the username and password have been set. Furthermore, there is a variable called base URL, which will be used in the URLs of all calls, so it will be easier to understand how the URLs are composed. Let's start with just calling the base URL. This returns a list of all available APIs. It is possible to get the metadata of the APIs by adding the parameter $metadata to the URL. This can be used to find out the exact structure of the returned data for each call and by development environments to generate code. All data in Dynamics 365 is related to a specific company or administration. The API Companies returns a list of all available companies for the user. Each record that is returned by the Dynamics 365 API has a unique ID. This ID must be used in a URL to refer to a specific record. With a simple JavaScript command, this data can be stored into an environment variable in Postman so it can be used in further calls. For example, we can use it in the Companies method to get that data for a single company. All company-specific data must be just use the company's ID part in the URL. For example, this is the URL that returns the list of available journals in the company. And with the accounts method, we get a list of existing general ledger accounts. The APIs also support filtering. Here we see how to filter the list of general ledger accounts to all accounts of the category liabilities. This is how to get a list of customers in the company. We store the ID in an environment variable because we are going to use this customer in the next calls. Let's first get the single customer by specifying the ID in the URL. The next thing to explore is how to update existing records. We do that by using the HTTP patch method. In the headers, we must specify the if match header. This is used for optimistic concurrency. The value of the if match header is an e tag that we got with the previous API call. In other words, we must first read the record to get its e tag, and then we can use that e tag in the if match header to update the record. To modify an existing record, we need to send data with the request. This is done in the request body. The body contains JSON data, and we specify the content type in the header. In the body, we only need to specify which fields we want to modify. Here, we change the property display name. The old name was Alpine's keyhouse, and we now change that to a different value. The return value reflects the updated record. The items API gives a list of existing items in a database that can be sold. We are going to use an item in one of the next calls, so we need to get the ID and store it in a variable. The Sales Invoices API gives a list of invoices in Dynamics 365. The result value gives us only the sales invoice header and does not include nested items like invoice lines. Again, every entity in the list has a unique ID. To get the invoice lines, we need to call the Sales Invoice Lines API and provide the ID of the invoice in the URL. The return value is an array of sales invoice lines. In the metadata, you can see that the sales invoice has a sales invoice lines annotation, amongst others. It is possible to request the sales invoice, including the lines, by providing the expand parameter and the annotation name. The result is an invoice including it lines. This feature makes it possible to read nested or related data with one call instead of multiple calls. We have seen how to read and update data. The last example is how to create a new sales invoice. The API is the same as used before, but now we use the post method instead of get. In the body, we provide the customer ID and other data that is needed for the invoice. The result is a new invoice with, again, a unique ID. We store this ID in a variable so we can use it to create one or more lines with the Sales Invoice Lines API. The usage of the Sales Invoice Lines API is just the same. We use the POST method and send a body with the data in it. The data contains a sequence number, item ID and quantity, and a shipment date. After you have clicked on send, it will have created the new sales invoice lines. Let's have a look in Dynamics 365 at the created sales invoice. The number of the sales invoice can be found in the result of the sales invoice API. Here you see this invoice in Dynamics 365, which we have created using the APIs. It is also possible to create an invoice including the lines with just one call. For this, we just post a body to the Sales Invoices API that includes both header and lines data. So, in this video, we started with exploring the APIs. We have seen how to set the web service key for usage in a development environment, And we used Postman to explore the behavior and the possibilities of the APIs. So as topics that we have covered, we have talked about APIs for Dynamics 365, about user authentication and calling web services. For more information, we refer you to the links displayed on the screen.